So, hello to everyone. This is again Dr. Jay Mehta here. And see, this is a sample of a TEFNA. This is a testicular seminiferous tubule, which we have just obtained, all right? Okay? This is a seminiferous tubule, as you can see. I'm just going to place it under the microscope. This is under the stereo zoom microscope, right in the center. I'm going to try and show you how it looks from inside of the microscope, all right? See that? You can see this. This is exactly how it looks from the inside, okay? Let me try and zoom it as close as I can. Okay? It's let me just try and do that for all of you. And you will be able to see this. See this? This is the exact way in which a seminiferous tubule looks inside of the microscope. See, I'm trying to zoom it so that I can show it to all of you. Now, there are certain aspects which are very important. This tubule, according to me, seems to be slightly healthy. This is a good tubule, okay? And I think from this tubule, I will be able to probably obtain some sperms. So, I'm going to show you the exact technique through which this entire effort of teasing a seminiferous tubule occurs, alright? So, the camera now goes in the hands of my assistant Anusha, and you know, I'm going to use two small tuberculin syringes. You see, I have placed some Hepis out here. So, what I'm going to do is, under the microscopic vision, I'm going to lift up the seminiferous tubule. Okay, just lift up. See that? The whole thing got lifted. And I'm going to put it inside of this droplet which I've just prepared. Now, at the same time, a glass slide with a microscope is going to be kept ready. Now, see, this goes inside. So, what I'm going to do is, very gently, you will now start to notice the hand movements. I'll show you the hand movements first, and then I'll show you how it looks inside the microscope, okay? See the hand movements. I'm holding one part of the tubule, and I'm trying to break it up. This, no, I highly encourage all people to do this, especially practicing IVF consultants. Even if you are a busy IVF clinic, you must do this on your own. Now see, as a clinic like us, where we don't do the donor sperm and donor egg program and all these things, you know, such cases and getting success rate in such cases is very, very important for us. Okay? So what I did is, in my initial practice, I learnt all these techniques on my own as to how to do the dissection, how to mash up the tubules. You can see that the tubules are getting mashed up into small parts and small pieces now, okay? Just in case, you know, there are always questions that is Jay actually doing it, or he has kept somebody as an assistant and somebody else is doing it. Probably you can even... You can see the tattoo on my hand, so I think it is the same person who is Jay Mehta, who is doing all these things. I don't believe that there is any restrictions in doing these things. As IVF consultants, I believe we must learn these techniques. They are going to help us, okay? So mash up this tubule into very, very small pieces, all right? Don't break it up completely. You don't want the entire tubule to be dispersed open. Just mash it up into small tubules, all right? Now see, this is a patient with a non-obstructive azoospermia, and we've begun with a trial TEFNA, okay? Because we thought the testicular volume is good. The consistency of the testis is also good. Alright. And see, if I've broken down the tubule now into multiple small pieces, okay? So what will happen is, when I put this tubule under the microscope, okay, you will be able to see that there is going to be a huge difference, okay? There will be a huge difference. I'm going to show this picture from inside of the microscope to you. See this? Let me just try and get the picture. Here we go. Now you see, it is mashed up into beautiful multiple small tubules. Can you put that in the center? Yeah, more towards your right. Yeah, see this? It is broken up into multiple small tubules, all right? Now, these small tubules are the ones which are going to be observed under the microscope. Move it more towards your right. Yeah, see this? These are all small tubules, okay? I have broken it up into multiple small parts, and I am going to try and do this observation under the microscope now. See this, you can see it is fragmented. It's beautifully fragmented into small, 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 small parts. And let us just see how it looks under the microscope now. Okay? So what we do is, I'm going to use a very small part of it. Very small part, okay? I don't want a big tubule to come with me. That's the aspirate there. This much. Maybe this much, little more. That's the tubule which I don't want. Okay. I believe this much is enough currently. Let me just place it in the center of the glass slide. I'll keep some space to place one more channel if I need. Okay. Let's have the cover slip on it. So we've got the cover slip and I'm going to cover it with the cover slip and I'm going to shift the screen image straight to the microscope. Okay, so you are going to now see the screen straight. And through the screen, I'm going to try and show you if we've got any sperms or not. Okay. Now remember, as far as non-obstructive azoospermia is concerned, your sperm retrieval rate, no? Is going to be around 55 to 60% and not more than that. Okay, so let us just try and zoom it further. This seems to be the testicular tubule, a small part of the tubule which we've mashed up. Okay, and I'm trying to observe it. It's a very small sample which I've taken. Okay, always try and go close to these aspects. If there are sperms, you're going to get the sperms right here. Okay, let's screen. We need to screen close to 100 high power fields before we go on to the next sample. So see, here is our first sperm. See that? Right in the center. I'm going to zoom it down further for all of you. Okay, absolutely in the center. See, in the center of the screen, you can see the first sperm there. See this? This is the first sperm. Okay, so you got the sperm. One. This is sperm number one. I have 14 eggs which I am supposed to do ICSI, so I've got one sperm already. Okay, so that means this sample is having sperms. So that means our clinical examination was right. That also means that our technique of doing TEFNA was right. Alright, and such things, no, are going to come only and only with enough experience. Don't expect you to do the first case and then think that in the first case itself you will have sperm retrieval. These are little bit difficult situations, you know. So one good sperm I have got already. Let me see if I can visualize some more. I will always see there is one more. Can you see right in the center? See this? See, this is sperm number two, right in the center. Sperm number two. See that? But this is not a very great sperm, okay? This is not a very great sperm. I don't like this sperm a lot. Let me see some other sperm. This is a sperm without a flicker. So I don't like this sperm. Let me see if I can get more sperms. Sperm number 3. See this? See this? This is sperm number 3. This is a good sperm. According to me, this is a good sperm. I will be able to use it for ICSI. If I culture it, let's say if I culture it for 2 hours, I will be able to get some flicker inside this, or I will use the laser to stimulate this sperm. But this is a good sperm. So I've got three sperms in 6 high power fields already. Okay, let me scan some more. See, the importance of this technique, no, is to find sperms in azoospermia. This is very, very important in my humble opinion. It's very, very important to do this technique in the right manner. See this one more sperm, please. See this? This is a beautiful sperm. This is a sperm which I'm going to be using. This is the other sperm which I'm going to be using. You can see that. This is the third, fourth sperm which I am going to be using on top. So I've got good 4-5 sperms. Let me see some more. Please keep the sample in the incubator. So see, that testicular sample which we have mashed up is now going to go inside the incubator. Okay, it is going to be cultured for the next 2 hours or so. And then I'm going to be doing ICSI. Okay, this is a sperm, but it is an unhealthy sperm. Let me just show it to you in the center. This is not a good sperm. This is a sperm. This is an unhealthy sperm. I'm not going to use this sperm. Okay. Allow me to culture this and I think I'll be able to get a good result on this. I'm just trying to find out something more accurate, something more as a cluster of sperms if I can get. I've finished visualizing around 20 fields. I need to visualize close to 100, as I've always stated. Even if you find sperms, please visualize the 100 fields. Keep this as a theory, routine. You must visualize 100 fields. Always. Don't give up. See this. One more. Great sperm. This is a very, very good sperm right here in the center. I believe all of you can see this as a sperm right here in the center. This is a very good sperm. See, now this is a patient who has presented to us with Sertoli cell syndrome. Okay. Testicular biopsy done outside Sertoli cell syndrome. And in the first trial Tefna itself, we've obtained the sperms. One of the important reasons to consider in such situations, and one take home point for all of you, is that testicular biopsy is outdated, guys. And second thing, I really, really urge all of you, I believe are much more intelligent, well-trained, smart than what I am. And you must, as IVF consultants, do this procedure on your own. Don't be reliant on your embryologist. Even if your embryologist is the world's best embryologist, this is a technique which you should learn to do on your own. And I think that is a very, very important take-home point for people who want to do surgeries on azoospermia. Okay? So, I'm close to 60 to 70 fields. I'm still expanding my fields and I'm going to see where I find sperms. But this is a very good retrieval. I think I will be able to easily perform ICSI in such situations. There is going to be no problem. Okay? I think it's going to be easy. We are close to 80 fields now. And we are very soon going to be approaching 100 fields. Once we reach 100 fields, as I said, we have sperm retrieval. See here, there are two sperms in a cluster here. See this? See this? There are two, three sperms in a cluster here. See? This is sperm number one. You can see there are the other sperms placed in a cluster. You see this? So this is very, very good. I'm going to allow this to be cultured. I will get motile sperms. These are good sperms. These are live sperms. I have around 14 oocytes where I am supposed to do ICSI. Before I finish, let me please tell everyone that fertilization rates are going to be very good, but implantation rates are going to be approximately 20% to 22 to 23%. In some cases, around 18-15% in situations of microtisa. And see, this is my last field and I've still got a sperm in the last field. So on an average, I've got a retrieval of close to 15-16 sperms in this entire procedure. And with this sperm retrieval, I conclude this entire session. So thank you very much, each and every one of you, for taking out time and watching this entire procedure. I believe such procedures are going to be extremely beneficial in counseling your patients, in helping them achieve a success rate in cases of azoospermia where they want to do a treatment using their own sperms. All right. Thank you so much. And we'll come back with many more very interesting live sessions in embryology, as I have promised for this year. Bye bye.